from the book of Isaiah. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had six wings. With two they covered their faces, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me! I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send, and who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. "So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led to the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If, in fact, we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, We know that you are a teacher who has come from God. For no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God. Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know, and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things, and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Nicodemus said to Jesus, "How can anyone be born after having grown old?" Jesus said, "What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes or where it goes. In the name of God, who sends us forth in the Holy Spirit. Amen." So we've all arrived today at Memorial Day weekend with a sigh of relief. Life is beginning to open up, and we're beginning to make summer plans to see friends and family. Now, there's a train too, right? It started up again. One of the highlights of many summer vacations for many people is a trip to the beach. And many of you may have a favorite beach that you go to year after year. For many years, when our children were little, right through high school and into college, we went to the Outer Banks and Hatteras Island. And for a decade or so, we stopped after college, and we had not been back to the beach again. But now, with grandchildren and other grandparents living at the beach in Manio, North Carolina, we'll probably start making a regular summer trip once again. Now, one of our favorite things to do at the beach is have a beach day. As many as we can if the weather is good. And a beach day works like this. You get up and out to the beach after breakfast as soon as you can. Now, because of all the things we take to the beach and the suntan, sun lotion, Brogaine, and all of that, usually by 11. But of course, this becomes more difficult with teenagers who want to have a raccoon schedule of late nights awake and late mornings rising. But we try to get there at 11, nevertheless. When our children were little, we tried to get out to the beach with sunscreen on and snacks and lunches made. Then we began the trudge to the beach, which involved carrying beach umbrellas, beach chairs, boogie boards, the sand pail and shovels, and all the things, walking or running on the beach, until we trudge back for naps and movies to settle in for supper and then games in the evening, with maybe a trip for ice cream and putt-putt. And my son always wanted to go to the go-kart place, and we always said no, and then eventually he got us to go. That's the beach day. It was relaxing, except for one thing. The parental responsibility that always hangs over a parent, grandparent, or adult at the beach. Watching the children and now grandchildren in the waves. Now, especially when your child is old enough, or thinks they are old enough, to go into the ocean on their own, that's where it's hard. And it's always there in the back of your mind and in your heart, how do we keep them safe from a riptide or going under or going out too far? And of course, you begin to realize that your worry as a parent is always in your heart and mind, no matter how old your child is and if they're at the ocean for a summer vacation. My own daughter, some of you know, is 8 weeks away from delivering her first child. If I could, I would have the baby for her. She is so very apprehensive about the delivery. I wish I could take away her worry. But all I can do is be there, by her side as much as I can, to reassure her that she knows the way. This coming week, my oldest granddaughter is arriving from Hong Kong for the summer as a 13-year-old. My job as a grandparent is to be present for her and walk with her in that confusing time of being an adolescent. I'd love to take away her confusion and anxiety as she makes her way into adulthood, but I can't. All I can do is be there with her, by her side as I can, to reassure her that she knows the way. A nearby spiritual director and poet named Kathleen Henderson Stout has written a book of poetry entitled Waving Back, Poems of Mothering Life. And I found the book tucked away within a box with some baby items that I was pulling out of storage for Anna. As I read this poem, I had some tears, but it captured how I feel now in my life. But it also seemed apt today for Memorial Day weekend and the blessing of our pandemic memorial garden. It captures those moments on summer vacation at the beach, but I think it also captures the role of those of us who are transitioning into a parental role, or an elder role, or even a role as an ancestor who lives on in the spirit. Someone we see no longer, but who always watches over us. It's called Waving Back. I remember the summer your body first began to stretch. We went, just you and I, to a salt pond by the seashore. You loved it because it was broad and shallow and you could wade out into it and leave me behind. I sat on the shore and watched you, the growing body in blue stripes. With every few steps, you would turn and wave and see me waving back. The water gets deeper, you stretch out taller, swim forward, dive under, look back less. But my part doesn't change. I watch from the beach, and when you turn to check, I am still here, ready to wave back. As I noted during the pandemic, we are always arriving and always leaving one another. And we do that as creatures of the flesh. But as Jesus reminds Nicodemus and all of us today, we are always together with one another in the Spirit. And our elders, whether in the flesh or now in the Spirit, are always standing and watching us as we move forward into the world. That's why cemeteries and memorial gardens are so important, and why we visit them and care for them. As we pass by their memorial spots, we have a sense that in the Spirit, those we love and see no longer are waving back to us for that day, for that moment, always and forever. They do that with God, who does that as well. Now, as we go out to the pandemic memorial at the end of the service, think of your beloved that are standing on another shore as you wade into the world, always watching you, waving back in love. There's Aunt Kay and Rick waving, and Charlotte Papp out, and Theta Nana Lawrence, and Brother Mickey Hatter, and Brother David Riggs, and Helen Lee, and Cecil Bell, and all the blood. They are all on the other shore in God's care, loving us still as God loves us. I remember the summer your body first began to stretch. We went, just you and I, to a salt pond by the seashore. You loved it because it was broad and shallow, and you could wade out into it and leave me behind. I sat on the shore and watched you, the growing body in blue stripes. With every few steps, you would turn and wave and see me waving back. The water gets deeper. You stretch out taller. Swim forward, dive under, look back less. But my part, our part, God's part, doesn't change. We watch from the beach, and when you turn to check, we are still here, ready to wave back. Let us stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are Form 3, is found in your bulletin. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice
compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
We pray especially for recovery from surgery of Ron Brown, for healing for Janice Nesterek, for continued healing for Ruthie Goldman, for a childbirth upcoming for Anna Angelosi and Barbara Jean Moore, and we give thanks for the life of Danny Nichols. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving and grace. So clothe us in your spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. I'd ask you to be seated as we bless the Book of Names. As we began the pandemic and we began to lose those that we loved, or knew of those that we loved that were lost, we thought that we would begin a book of names for anyone who died during this period, because so many people were unable to celebrate the lives of those they love that they see no longer. This book is open and will continue to be open as we move forward. And if there's a name that's missing as I read the list, please let me know that it made you think of someone who's waving back to you in your life from beyond. Please do let us know and we'll inscribe their names. Emmanuel's Book of Names, begun in 2019. Carol Ali, Helen Lee Alvall, Diana Beverly, Rex Burton, Marianne Chapman, Emily Arnone, Cecil George Bell Jr., Richard Madison Blair, Richard Baraka, Beth Brothers, Ethel Crump, Wendy Dimler, Catherine Emmerich, Ken Fisher, Marcia Mackey Goss, Arthur Stanley Davis, Naoma Joanne Davis, Mary Brooks Steele Estes, Sandy Fisher, Sue Grabenstein, Elmer B. Bree, Jr., Michael Charles Hatter, Janet Hendershot, Richard Holt, Charlie Hout, Richard Harris, Ann Harris, Patrick Kevin Hogan, Sarah Averett Hoover, Nellie Piper Leary, Kevin Lynch, Theda Martz, Bob McCullough, Betty Jo Murphy, Rudolph Napolitan, Marilyn Madden, Sean McGaw, Rick McDonald, Margaret Murphy, David Kerr Riggs, Kathy Rosenthal, Tom Tribute, Tom Trussell, Elizabeth Staley, David Talley, Betty Tribute, Dr. Wayne Spiegel, and Albert Vians. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servants, listed in our Book of Names. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, sheep of your own fold, lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming. Receive them into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand for the peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
to, after the service, to take a look at the Book of Names. One of the things that I love to do is do special handwriting, so it was real labor of love to write those names, and as I wrote them, I thought of each of those people and prayed for them. So thank you for that honor. Welcome on this Memorial Day weekend, Sunday, to Emmanuel Parish, and today we're going to continue the blessing of our garden, our pandemic garden that is in process, with the planting of the geraniums that we had on the altar when we regathered on May 2nd. And during the postlude, I'd invite all of us to follow Brad as he brings the cross down and out into the garden. And then I'm going to call on folks that I know have someone in the Book of Names to place the plant in a hole already dug. We've got the plants out there. You don't have to cover them up with soil. And if you can't lean over, Brad and Scott will be, Scott Reaver will be there to help place the plant there. So please follow us out. The choir will sing at the beginning of that when we arrive outside. And we will end by Cecil Bell's spot in the Memorial Garden, which is under the dogwood tree by Emmanuel House, and that will be the site of the pandemic memorial. So we ask you to stand kind of below the hill, that little hill that rises up, as Pastor Marsha puts the box in the hole, and then the choir will sing the final Jesus is Calling, and we'll have a dismissal. But that's the plan for at the end of the service. Please do let me know if there's someone who you didn't hear on the list that should be on the list, or someone you thought of, and we can put them in. And everyone going forward will be in this Book of Names who are among our dearly departed. Another wonderful thing of altar ward and vestry member Brad Williams, from his inventive mind, he has suggested that we all gather on the hill out front. I guess it's that way, right? And for tomorrow's Del Curry Canal Place free concert, because they're expecting between, I understand, 500 to 1,000 people down at Canal Place to hear this free concert when Del Fest usually is. Del Curry and his band are here from 2 to, well, I think he'll probably play at 3, but the concert's from 2 to 5 tomorrow afternoon. So we thought, I'm sure there's some other people that have thought of this too, not just us, about having a picnic, bringing our own picnic and all sitting together out on the hill from 2 to 5. So Brad's right there. Raise your hand, Brad, if you've got questions, and hope to see you there tomorrow. If you haven't, if you don't get the Nova, or you haven't looked at it from this weekend's Nova that we sent out Friday, there's a wonderful audio recording of Stephanie Gates, who was at our Thursday Bible study. And Stephanie worked very closely with Bo Chapman around tours during her time here. She's part of the famous Gates family. And she talked about her history in Cumberland as a young person, her history at Emmanuel, at St. Philip's, and at Holy Cross. And so you really want to hear that. And we'll send it out again in the next few Novas. But if you have a problem finding it, please contact us in the office. It's a wonderful, about 45-minute talk. And it tells you some of the things about our altar in the Chapel of the Resurrection, which was here originally and went to St. Philip's, which was on Smallwood Street, and then when that closed, went to Holy Cross, and then came back here. So, next week begins our summer schedule, and it is different this summer that we will not have 10 a.m. We will have 8 a.m. Rite 1, and we'll have 5 p.m. Rite 2. 8 a.m. will be those wonderful historic words of the Anglican tradition. It will be a said service without music. At 5 p.m., we'll be up here for 8 a.m. At 5 p.m., we're going to open the back doors if it's not too hot and sit back there under the Second Coming window, which is beautiful in that late afternoon. It will be a very contemporary, informal service of Holy Eucharist. And Amy Armiento is going to be, who, if you didn't know, she's a professor of English at Prosper State, but she's also an accomplished church musician. She'll be with us this summer for a lot of our Sundays, and we'll be singing today's A Chant and some very simple music. So if you would like a contemplative experience, either early morning or late afternoon, join us. Why we're doing this is for several reasons. We want to get back and see where we are in the fall, because we could open up things even more, perhaps without masks. But we also need to get all our teams together, our altar board, our lectors, our greeters. There's a lot to do to make this service happen. And for those of us that have been putting it together, we are missing some of you and need you very much. So we're going to start recruiting folks, and this is a good time to join how we put the service together at 10 a.m. So that's the plan there. We always have our Thursday noon Eucharist, if you like middle of the day. So you can always join us in the Mary Chapel on Thursdays. The flowers this morning are in memory of Ralph Miller. And I did mention Ron Browning. He had a vertebrae procedure in his neck on Wednesday, and he did very well, and he hopes to be back with his soft collar on, doing tours soon. Ruthie Goldblum made another trip to the hospital, but we're hoping that she's on her way home. Please pray for her and Donald. And Terry Nichols lost her nephew in Indiana and has been there for a funeral, so please keep the Nichols family in prayer during this time. And please pray for safe delivery for Anna Cantalosi and Robert G. Ward, as well as our Hong Kong family is coming back to the United States for good, and they're going to start coming back in the next few weeks. So please keep all of that in prayer for Brian and myself. Yes, Terry.
I just want to let you know that it's almost strawberry time. Pigskins have started picking. I think this cool weather and rain will slow it down a bit, so I'm hoping we will not get ours until next week. But please watch the Nova, or for the Friday Nova, or another email from Karen saying of which days and times we're going to be doing strawberries. So I would appreciate your help. Thank you.
Yeah. And if you don't remember, Heritage Days has been moved to the second weekend of September, and we're going to be central from a central location for the Will Street Muster. I understand Barbara, and Barb Crane knows all about that, and we're going to have all sorts of conditions of 18th century craftspeople and reenactors in this space right outside in the garden. So it'll be very exciting. So now we'll sing our offertory hymn all together, My Country, 'Tis the Thee, which is in your bulletin, and then have the Eucharist together. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
My God. as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Let us pray together the post-communion prayer. Eternal God,
Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son and Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have us as spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage in the gospel of mercy, with the Lord and the Sinner in his heart, through Christ our Lord.
Before the blessing, I'd like to invite Pastor Marshall to come up to receive Cecil's ashes. So, Pastor Marshall will wait in the Chapel of the Resurrection and follow the cross at the postlude, which Brad will carry. I invite you all to the garden after the closing hymn, which is one of those great Anglican hymns, but it's a little long. So sing with gusto with your last line. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Yeah. us over to the dog in the tree there and help us stay down the hill, but we're going to receive Cecil's ashes there. And take a look afterwards. There's a lovely bird sculpture there. So, come on out. I'd like Charlie to put Aunt Kay's flower in right here, right in the middle. Michael Charles Hatter. Let's see, Scott, if you could come up and help Bob, we're going to put David's flower in right here. Bob's brother, David Riggs. Around the corner and do the Hout Marks family. Pretty them up.
McDonald. And David. Marts and Kathy Rosensteel. And then we have one more before we go to Cecil's. I think there's one right. Is there one left?
Right here.
So this will be the all the dearly departed, and we can name their names now. And if, let's see, Scott, if you would put those in, please. So if you could think of someone who will be waving to you, say their name silently or loud. Winfield Scott McGill, Anna Britt McGill, Ed Kelleher, Margaret Bryan, Kitty Kelleher, Gary Kelleher, Jack Martin. All right, so now we're going over. Please follow us to sing, I'd like to do a blessing for the garden. We seem to give them back to thee, dear God, who gavest them to us, but not as the world giveth, givest thou, O lover of souls. For what is thine is ours always if we are thine. And life is eternal and love is immortal, and death is only a horizon save the limit of our sight. Bless these pandemic gardens as they grow. Help the children to run through them with glee, knowing that the ancestors are there, waving back, helping us to go on and live. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Jesus is calling to you.
Thanks be to God.